Hi friends, welcome to my channel. This is Nima Kiran and today I'm going to show you how to make butterfly wings with cloth for dance, or you can also use it for a Halloween costume. Friends, please watch the full video without skipping so that you can understand the step-by-step procedure for making the butterfly wings. First, I'll show you how to make the wings. As the wings are too big, I'm showing how to make a model in an A4 size paper. It is always good to use a silk satin material to get the flowy nature. And remember to buy a cloth that has enough width so that you can use the entire width to cut the cloth. For one pair of wings, I used 3 meters of cloth. Take the cloth and cut it into half, so you get 1.5 meters each for each side. Now, measure the full length of the person from the shoulder to the toes using a measuring tape. And for the horizontal width, take the measurement from the middle of the neck to the fingertip. Now, for your reference, I am showing here 15 centimeter as the full length on the A4 size paper and 10 centimeter as the width. Now here you can see that in this paper I have marked the 15 centimeters as length and 10 centimeter as the width for your reference. And now we need to make a circular pattern on the bottom side so that the wings will appear like the butterfly wings. Okay, for that we'll take the 15 centimeter, the full length, and draw lines like this from the center of the neck so that you get a circular pattern at the bottom. Now, as you can see that I have completed drawing the circular pattern, and on the width side you can see that I have left the rest of the 5 centimeters so that I can attach a stick or a cane onto it so that you get a more wider wings. See, you can fold it over here and then put a stick onto it and then stitch it so that you can hold it with your hands properly. Now make sure the entire circumference is 15 centimeters and then cut onto the sides of the wings, and then you will get a piece like this. Then either you can make it as a template and then cut the second wings, or else you can again take the measurement and then do the second part of the wing. Now as you can see, I have got 2 pieces over here, and then arrange the pieces in such a way that the hand width and the length is in the proper manner. Here you can see again, I'm folding the piece where I can attach the stick onto, and the second piece I'm marking the height and the hand length. Now place the 2 pieces properly, and next we need to make the neck piece so that we can attach it to the wings, and then you can fold that around your neck and use it as the proper 2 sides of the wings. Now fold the paper or the piece of the cloth into 4 pieces according to the size of your neck, and then the middle part of this piece you need to attach it to the wings. You can use a Velcro to connect the 2 ends of the neck pieces together, and then you will get a full wing. Now we need to make the template for the original size of the wings. Here you can see that I have already cut the wing, and that is on the back side, which you can see as the orange color. And then I have drawn the pattern on 2 pieces of chart paper, and then I have cut it according to the original size of the wings. And after drawing the pattern, here I have drawn the monarch butterfly pattern. After drawing the pattern, I have using a sharp cutter, I have cut the pattern so that I can get a template of the whole design. Now as you can see that I'm cutting out the template I have already drawn. I have cut it with using a sharp cutter, and then the one side of the wing template is ready. You can make as many wings you want using this template, and for the other side you just have to turn it to the opposite side, and you can use it as the template for the next side also. Now, on a flat surface, first you have to lay down the wings on which you are going to make the pattern, and then using a masking tape you have to fix the template onto the onto that orange color cloth, and then take a permanent marker, preferably black color. I'm using a black colored permanent marker over here, and using that marker you have to draw down the pattern of the wings onto the cloth. As you can see here, I'm drawing the pattern carefully onto the cloth, and be careful not to smudge it all together. Now you can see that using the template I have already drawn the pattern onto the butterfly wing cloth. Now we need to paint the wings. Here I have used acrylic color in order to paint the wings. I took it in a ratio of 1:2, one part acrylic color and two part water. And before painting the acrylic color onto the wings, you have to place it on top of a cardboard or anything that is and that is hard. Don't use newspapers. Here I have used newspapers, but finally after painting, it got stuck onto the underside of the wings. So be careful not to use newspapers or any paper which is thin. You can use cardboard or any other kind of hard material which will not get fixed onto the underside of the wings. And here you can see that I'm painting on that pattern carefully. Now you can see I am almost done with my wing pattern of one side, and it is better that you always try the paint on some other piece of cloth or any leftover piece of cloth, and then you try it onto the wings. It will take almost 24 hours for that acrylic paint to dry up completely, and after that you can lay over the butterfly wings again onto a flat surface. And like you can see, I'm applying some glue here and there on the black colored paint all over the butterfly wing, and then I'm sprinkling some silver colored glitter on top of it. And you can do this as your wish all over the black colored portion on the wings. Here, instead of the silver color glitter, you can also simply use white acrylic paint which can be painted instead, and then you can leave it for drying up, and after drying up you will get a proper wing pattern of the monarch butterfly. Here, as you can see, the butterfly wings is almost over, and I have spread it over there for drying. You need to dry the butterfly wings completely, and then I'll be attaching the collar onto the butterfly wings. Now, as you can see, the butterfly wings is almost over, and with the template which I showed you, I made almost 7 pairs of wings. You can use different wing patterns according to your wish. You just have to make the template of the same size of the wings which you want to make. Now you can see that all the 7 pairs of wings are ready and my dancers are ready with their costumes. Hope you like the video, and if you like the video, please subscribe my channel and hit the bell icon for all the latest notifications. Thank you and have a nice day.